It's the 2022 Santa Cruz.
Yes.
The truck that you think wasn't ever going to be built again by any manufacturer.
It's the Cruz Camino.
It's been tried before.
The Elka Cruz? I don't know.
The Ford Ranchero, the Holden Maloo, Subaru Brat, the Baja.
It's a Ute. That's the key thing. Here in the U.S., we now get a Ute.
It truly is. But it works. So it's a little trucklet.
It is a trucklet. Absolutely a trucklet.
A little bit different.
There's no question that it is. My wife's not a fan because she hates the El Camino. She looked at it and said, that's a Kruk.
Yeah.
Well, the Kruk is back. The Ute is here. I'm actually quite excited about it. The minute I saw it, I thought, that actually looks great. It's compact without looking unsubstantial. It's like, that's got got power feel to it, but yet it's actually really little.
You're watching Everyday Driver. We make a TV show, podcast, and YouTube channels dedicated to great cars, driving adventures, and helping you find a car you'll love. Subscribe and hit the bell so you don't miss a thing.
You might think that it's not a real truck, and if it's not a real truck and buying this means that it's better to drive, easier to park, more comfortable, better fuel economy, and it costs less than a real truck, well, yes, it's not a real truck.
True. Well, you
can. But it can do most of the truck things
that
most people need. If you really evaluate your truck needs, this will do 90% of the truck things you need. Unless you're installing barbed wire out on a ranch somewhere, or you're towing a horse trailer. Do you need a big pickup truck?
We've talked about the Honda Ridgeline a few times
yep.
with exactly that thinking, because really it is the more usable truck body style.
Yep.
The problem is that the Ridgeline has always, even with the refresh, felt a little soft and it doesn't look cool. And as much as styling is subjective, this just looks cool and it still looks aggressive, which is interesting. Two things the Ridgeline doesn't do, it feels honestly to drive a little more truck-like than the Ridgeline. I will say this, the Ridgeline has a better ride. The Ridgeline on the road has a better ride than this.
This is good.
But
I like this.
But here's the interesting reason why. Hyundai has taken this Ute idea. This is why I think it's a Ute. Because this is what the Australians
did. Can we just nix that word from our English vocabulary?
It's an Australian word, and the reason that they love them is because it's that weird car, truck,
thing. It's the Maloo. It's the Holden Maloo.
With a ton of power up front, which makes it fun to drive, and then the pickup bed in the back. That's why this is Ute. This has got 280 horsepower, 311 pound-feet of torque, an 8-speed dual clutch.
Yeah.
This is genuinely fast and genuinely fun to drive, which I am amazed to say.
I agree, yes.
The flip side is the ride is stiffer and feels more sporting than it does in the Ridgeline. So now you're getting closer to, I would say, a truck-style ride, but no truck has this chuckability.
Agreed.
I have never been in anything that has a truck look and doesn't have something about it that feels a little lumbering.
Mm-hmm.
This has none of that. This is just agile and like, I want to go. What are we
it
doing?
Is.
Let's
it's
do
spry.
Something fun.
It's spry. Okay, both models of the Santa Cruz come with a 2.5-liter inline four.
Yes.
One is turbocharged, one is not. The lower power truck makes 190 horsepower, 180 pound-feet of torque.
Don't get that one.
It comes with the 8-speed automatic. There is a difference. Now, in the turbo, we're in the limited all-wheel drive with a turbocharger, same engine, but now you get that really great dual clutch that Hyundai and Kia are putting in everything.
Yep.
It's either 7 or 8 speeds. So you actually have a dual clutch with paddles and sport mode in your driveline.
I can't even believe it. And it's genuinely fun to drive.
It's fun to drive.
The dual clutch is excellent. That is a lot of power for this little guy to be. It weighs about 4,000 pounds. So I did not expect it to be fun to drive.
Agreed.
I expect it to be a better looking,
useful
Ridgeline competitor.
Yeah.
It doesn't ride as soft as a Ridgeline, but the Ridgeline never feels fun. It just feels capable. This feels fun, and I did not expect a sporting character in this at all. Now, downsides. It has a 4-foot bed. That is a tiny bed
if
you're used to hauling anything legit. But then I started thinking about it the way I would use a
truck. But that's what real truck means. Do you haul plywood a lot?
Fine. But 5-6 feet, that starts to get the thing that most people are looking for. This is a 4-foot bed, which is little. Now, it has an integrated tonneau cover, which is really cool.
Yep.
It has underbed storage, which is awesome.
Yep.
So I do like both of those features.
Like the Ridgeline.
But then I started to think about how I would use this if I owned it. And I realized what I'd do is it would be all that stuff that you take to the lake because it got nasty, like the paddle boards that are covered in junk, or the mountain bikes. The way you had a good day mountain biking is the bike got filthy and so did you.
Yep.
You toss the bike in the back, that 4-foot bed is perfectly big enough for that, and to its great surprise, this will tow 5,000 pounds, which if you're towing a big horse trailer, or a huge RV, it does not big enough. For most people, for most toys, 5,000 is what you're looking for, and it's perfect. This is, I know you don't like this term, a lifestyle truck. This is an off-roading, outdoor lifestyle truck, but for once, I don't mean it as an insult. It strikes me
fair
as
enough.
We sat around and went, what would make it fun to go outdoors? And the result is this, and it's genuinely fun.
Well, a quick note about the towing. It is the exact same as the Ridgeline.
Mm-hmm.
That's impressive. And it has self-leveling rear suspension mm-hmm. for your payload or mm-hmm. for the tongue weight of whatever you're towing. The Tacoma actually tows more. It's 6,400 pounds. But that's typical truck thinking. It's small.
Mm-hmm.
It's got a solid rear axle and a regular truck frame. When designers design an object and they use it for what it's intended, it's not designed in a vacuum, it's not just a styling exercise, it seems like Hyundai and the entire mm-hmm. design team thought about the outdoor activities and packed it full of stuff. You could get a bike back there, you know, with the pad, the Dakine
totally,
pad,
exactly
and you lean
right.
it, front
yep,
wheels over the back.
The way to do it for this,
or
for
get
sure.
the hitch rack and you're fine. But it is still kind of a truck because it does light off-roading, a
yes.
little bit of truck
yep.
kinds of things. We need to talk about the styling, though.
Mm-hmm.
I think it is excellent. It is modern. It is interesting. Big shout out to Terry Chen, a friend of mine, and the entire design team at the Hyundai Design Studio in California. That's where this was designed.
Yep.
Hyundai is keeping this triangular shape, but it comes off the cowl.
Right.
That line is repeated, yeah. and it drops into this triangular flat surface that is very much a signature Hyundai look
mm-hmm.
with a modern grille, very modern, clean, small lights. When you pull this truck up next to any other big full-size pickup truck, it looks tiny,
mm-hmm.
but it doesn't look cute.
Yeah.
Never tell a man his truck or his car is cute. Check out the tiny little icon at the top of each wheel arch
mm-hmm.
with the little truck logo. They wanted to do a little flip-out mount to mount your phone or a GoPro. It kind of looks like it would open, or there's some
yeah,
sort of latch
look like
system
it's
right
yeah.
there. They wanted the GoPro mount there. Too much complexity and cost and engineering. But we put a camera on that fender mount to actually show what the camera would be seeing. I think that would encourage more off-roading with this truck.
Or stupidity. Either
well,
or,
that
either
kind
one.
Of thinking
yeah.
is great.
Mm-hmm. It is. It's good.
All around. There's little Easter eggs. Even in the taillights, it says designed in California. And this was built in Alabama. So this is pretty much American as it gets.
Mm-hmm.
Now look on the inside. It seems mm-hmm. very welcoming. There's many cars you get in, you think, I don't relate to the shapes. I don't get it. It's not me. This is very much forward thinking, but it's clean. It's simple. It makes you want to dive in and use some buttons, even though there's not giant knobs. Wasn't
yeah, yeah.
sure about that.
I wouldn't
that,
mind a couple of knobs, but I take your point.
But it actually, knobs can make the interior look dated.
True. Okay, this one, like this, is $40,000. Now, there's a couple ways to look at that. On the surface, I feel like that feels like a lot of money for this. But then, when you get in it, the interior holds up to that price.
Yeah.
Which is
it does.
A surprise and a yeah. welcome surprise. Also, think about this, things like the Tacoma
mm-hmm.
or even the new Frontier that we've been in.
Sure.
If you rig those out to what you want it to be, they're going to be close to $50,000. And I don't think those interiors feel as nice as this does.
I agree to that.
Even the
yeah.
new Frontier,
yeah.
which we're a fan of, doesn't feel as premium in interior in just style and the way it works as this does.
Have you noticed this also answers the question, can you put vents above the screen?
Of course you can, and you should.
Before, it was just on the sides. Have you ever seen vents above the screen?
Very
in the
rarely.
Hierarchy
Very
of
rarely.
Things that are important, Hyundai knows truck owners, and they put the vents first.
And they've kept a really nice trim piece that the vents are part of all the
yep.
way along the highest part
yep.
of the interior. This seat never goes quite low enough for me. I want to be, and it's, I think it has to do with the sporting nature. I want to
yeah.
be down here, but
yeah.
then I realize, oh, it's truck thinking, so we're up high. I've got it as low as it goes. I have enough room. I'm not complaining about the amount of room. Because of the way this car drives and feels and the way the interior looks, I want to be like 6 inches lower in the car.
Sure.
It isn't going to be that way because
sure.
it's a truck. You probably won't notice or care. The other thing about it is lots of trucks in this segment, they have back seats, so
mm-hmm.
you can go, oh, look, I have back seats.
Right.
You
Check
can use these. Look, they're not huge, but they're decent. You could get adults back there for a little bit of time. You can actually take your friends and go somewhere
mm-hmm.
in this, and everybody's okay.
Yep.
That's hard in a Tacoma.
Yep.
The Tacoma's hard just in the front seats, let alone
Agreed.
The back. This could be a daily.
Yes.
That would
yes.
feel a little bit sporty, but yet you said, I'm a truck person. I think that's a niche that nobody else is hitting.
At first glance, it just looks like the idea that everybody's tried.
Mm.
Hyundai has kind of redefined that. I feel like there was restraint, but good ideas involved here.
Is it the Uticruise?
Don't do that.
Okay, your turn.
The A pillars are pretty raked back.
Like sports car levels.
Very much so. And the C pillars kind of have this opposite effect. Mm-hmm. Everywhere you look is really paid attention to. It's like Mazda surfaces. How well designed and curated Mazda surfaces are, that's where Hyundai's at now. They have found their own signature look. The interface takes a little bit of getting used to.
You're being kind. I think it sucks.
You do?
I am not happy with Hyundai or Kia on interfaces. I don't think any of it is as intuitive as it should be.
I think it's perfectly intuitive.
And connecting up your phone is always harder than it should be in Hyundai and Kia products.
I had no problem.
Even getting to Apple CarPlay and all that, you've got to bring a cable. You've got to make sure you did it right. You've got to unlock 45 things. It all works. You'll only have that fight with it once.
And I didn't think it was that bad.
And it's not exclusive to this car. I've noticed that this is, so it's not Santa Cruz. It's Hyundai and Kia products. They just need to sort their interfaces out. They're becoming one of my least favorites.
Really?
Yes.
I mean, I think it's pretty straightforward, to be honest.
It's okay, but that's the thing. There are so many people that are doing it where it is just, oh, that was dead simple. This is okay. It works. They're being leapfrogged now, and now this one's starting to feel a bit old and a bit clunky.
Well, under setup, you can find the four different interfaces that Hyundai has, including the cube mode, where it measures RPM and speed in cubes. It's kind of funky, but it's fun. Nevertheless, it's kind of interesting. You get just a traditional shift knob, and then your drive modes are right behind the shift knob here. So you can go from normal, sport. We had it in smart with the diff lock on. Yep. And the interesting thing about this is, for sporty driving, it'll throw most of the torque to the back wheels. So it'll feel a little bit just like a traditional rear-wheel drive car. Mm-hmm. That's what gives it that sporty feel with a little bit tighter suspension. I actually don't mind that it's stiffer. I don't want this truck kind of ride.
What you're buying in this segment is you're buying a non-truck ride. But this has gone more like a stiff truck ride. But then when you drive it and you realize it was done for sporty, agile reasons, then you're accepting of it again.
Right.
It's not this big, stiff ride that is then lumbering. It's a big, stiff ride that is now agile and willing to jump around and is actually fun to drive.
Jump
and then
around.
I go, okay, thank you for that.
But it's not stiff like a solid rear axle
nails
you in the back.
No,
it's
not at all.
That kind of feeling. So you still get that nice, independent rear suspension. And it just moves.
It really does.
Turbo engine just makes this thing move.
Well, I left a couple of lights, and no one was ready for me.
Yeah.
Nobody expected this little thing to be as fast as it is. And it's fun.
So when people write to us and say, hey, guys, I need a sport utility vehicle. I need a sports activity vehicle.
Oh, yay. The S.
For the kids, for the activities, that's still a little bit fun to drive. Mm-hmm. People are not looking for a sports car. They know it isn't.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, I can't resist.
Puddle.
Ah.
Well done, sir.
I just like that. This is now in the category, because we recommend Mazda all the time and say, you want something useful and fun, you know, the people that brought you the Miata, they know what cars and vehicles should drive like. This is now in that category.
It
does hold corners. This torque split center clutch will actually throw power for medium and high speed corners too.
Mm.
So it's actually kind of helping you
through
corners.
Yes.
That's pretty cool. Mm-hmm. It's almost a little bit like taking a page from Subaru, rally kind of style, a little bit from Audi for Audi Quattro, and kind of making it their own.
The Baja Ute from
The Ute.
Yes.
Can we just get rid of Ute?
I have to lean into it because we've never had a Ute here.
We've never had a Ute.
Since the El Camino, we've been sans Ute.
I want a Brat.
This is the updated Brat, though.
Can you have Brat on your license tag?
Why not?
Buy one of these and get Brat.
I think that's perfect.
People would be like, yes.
The only thing you need to do is you need to figure out a way to have fold-down seats that can fit under the tonneau cover, and you just pop them up with the prize people.
As long as they have the jet fighter handles.
You better believe it. That's the key thing.
No seat belt, just handles.
Just the jet fighter handles.
Just hang on.
That'll be perfect, yeah. That's going to pass all the safety inspections. You definitely have to do that one for yourself, yeah. Hyundai's not going to sign off on that. The lawyers will show up.
Look, as far as the seating position is concerned, I think this will still appeal to people that want a truck and want that little bit higher ride height. I want to go down too, and it just won't go down anymore.
It's high and vertical, and that is truck feeling.
It's truck feeling,
yes.
And that appeals. Mm-hmm. Little things. It's not just a cobbled together exercise.
Because there's not a market. It was Ridgeline and everybody else.
Pretty
and
they've
now inserted themselves in the Ridgeline with a completely different
character. Pretty much. And they've kind of figured out their own flavor here.
And then Ford's showing up with the Maverick. So we're going to put the two of them together because they're fascinating. And they have different approaches just among themselves. I would have never expected, even including the styling, that Hyundai's approach would have been, let's make the sporty version.
Yeah.
I didn't expect that.
Well, have you also noticed the Ridgeline changed to give you the split between a truck cab and a truck bed to try to appeal to trucks, which I think was the wrong move. Mm-hmm. They invented it. And here's Hyundai doing the seamless thing between there is no cab, there is no bed. They've brought it back and said, no, 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 that was good. You were on to something and made it their own.
I think this may be as close as the real world actually gets to being able to own the Cybertruck. If you've liked the Cybertruck design, if you like that thinking, I think this is as close as the real world gets.
I'm not following.
I don't think the Cybertruck's really coming.
Oh, you don't? Okay.
No, I really don't think it is.
Well,
and as a result, maybe the people that have liked that people well, there's that one. People that have liked that non-truck look, this is a non-truck sci-fi look that is here and available now.
And
I know the
Tesla
fans are
not
going to go. They're not going
to
go shop Hyundai. I'm aware of all of these problems. I'm just saying, look-wise, this is the closest I think we're really going to get.
Okay. So if you had a deposit in for a Cybertruck,
you should
look at the Santa Cruz.
Didn't expect that.
Here it is. And go get muddy.
Yes,
this
for sure.
This thing is so great.
It's just fun.
Most stuff, for most people, it's going to do it. You put the right tires on here. You put some off-road tires or winter tires.
Yeah, we're doing it in just random street tires. And we're having a great time in nasty mud. This is like the mud they use for testing. It's that kind of mud, yeah.
It's epic movie quality mud. I want to park it with a wheel up on a rock.
You want to do the Jeep thing?
I totally want to do the Wrangler thing.